In this video, we are going to take a look into SparkReceipt. I'm going to explore what it is and how to use it and whether it is good at what it's supposed to do. Let's go into the video. First, what is SparkReceipt? SparkReceipt is a mobile application for Android, iOS, and also a web application which uses AI to automate your receipt scanning, which means you can add expenses, income, manage expenses and income. You just not need to do the entries manually. Instead, you just take a photo of your bill or receipts from your camera, or you upload to your web application, and it will automatically scan all the details in the receipts and bill, and automatically brings all the values from that image to the system itself, from merchant name, total value, items or tax. All these data will be gathered into it. It is using OCR, and with AI it is able to do that. So not only you are able to add entries manually, you also are able to add entries via OCR, which is AI scans, or you can automatically forward all the bills or receipt to a specific email address and it will automatically scan those data for that. Or you can upload bulk data in bank statements and everything, and from that it will automatically categorize and bring all the values into the system. So it does two things main primarily. One, helps you to scan your receipts with AI to get all the data automatically, and help you to manage your income and expenses for your personal life or even for your small business also. So this is the app SparkReceipt. I quickly wanted to show you one important information. If you scroll down, there is something called security. I highly encourage you guys to read through it, because when you go into this page, it clearly shows you where your data are stored, how your data are used, how it is communicated and everything. Because when you are handling with your financial information, it is always recommended to check out all these things, and I appreciate they are transparent with this, how they are using all this. So once you read through it, if you are satisfied with this, go ahead and start using this platform for you. It is available in all the different countries. All the currencies are supported, all the languages of bill also supported. App is also available in 5 languages. Okay, that is enough for the information of the app itself. Let me go and show you how it is used. You can use this on mobile app, as I mentioned, Android and iOS, and a web app as well. All of these are auto-synchronized. So when you add something on your mobile phone, it will show in your other platforms also. So that's why I'm using web. So it's easy for me to record and using it. You can download the Android app. I primarily use through Android app if I start using this app, because we can't expect to come into a web app and start using the system. We have a receipt on our hand. I want to take a photo. I want to categorize it. Simple as that. So now let me show you how all the different features available for you. All these features and functionalities are available on the mobile app itself. Just the interface is a bit different. Apart from that, everything is same. As soon as you come into this, there are a lot of elements in the dashboard, and you don't know where to focus on it. The first thing you should focus on it, this add new expense and add new income. So depending on which you want to add, you can do that. For example, when I click on add new expenses, it will open up a new window for me, which gives me all the option to add the manual data, which I'm not interested, because that is the boring way of doing it. If you wish, you can do it. Like if you prefer everything manual, you can go ahead. But what we are going to do is we are going to bring some receipts into play. You can see I have 3 different sample receipts here. Let me open up and show the quality of all the 3 different receipts. So this is very clear receipt. Like if you scan something or receive something via email or something, very clear. It should handle this no problem at all. Then I add another receipt. Here it's still good. Everything is legible, but you can still clearly see it's a paper, folded edges, folded areas and everything. So this is a second receipt I'm going to upload. Third, this is another receipt. Here you can see obviously it is a bad image, but this is kind of a receipt which we'll be using every day. So I want to test it out. Like when I take a picture. I'm not going to waste on what are the things available and everything. So I'm going to take this image as it is and try to scan and see how the result is going to be. Okay, so I'm coming into this screen. All you need to do is, if you are on a mobile phone, you just take a photo of the receipt. If you're on web app, click here and upload this receipt. So currently it is uploading. As soon as it's finished uploading, it is going to scan the document for the details. I'm going to keep it in real time so you can see how fast it is able to recognize things. You can see two things I want to show here, because I already tested all these things when I doing testing. So it is like showing me a possible duplicate. This is also good. For example, when you add some bills again and again, this system identify, okay, this is a duplicate, whether you want to add this document or you go with the original one, or you want to keep both the documents here. It is a good feature. I really like it. I keep this both document. You can see it uploaded this and it's showing me a review status. I can keep a review status here. Showing me a merchant name. It took the name here correctly. Date correctly done. Expenses, I marked it as an expense. Meals and entertainment, it read through these items and categorize this as a meals and entertainment. We also can edit the categories or add more categories. I'll show you. Payment method, it is not shown here how I paid, so it's blank. I can select a payment method which I have already created, and I can add more payment method as well as here. A reference, which took a series of number and marked it into a referent. This is also a bit inaccurate sometimes. For example, it took this as a reference. I'm not sure how it differentiate from these two as not reference number. Tax calculation, like if it found any tax values also, it shows, like it shows the total amount, it shows the tax amount and shows me the percentage and everything. So this is where it done all these things, tax included, and currency it detected as USD, you can see. And details, and I can also tag it. For example, friends, let me, whenever I do something, I will go with friends. I mark it as a friends tag. That way when I create reports or search through all the records, I can just put friends tag and I can see all the bills with friends. So you can use the tags to quickly identify some bills as well. So this is the first tag, invoice. Let me go with the new one, the second one. All these are tested. I'm testing it again for you guys. Scanning document, so it's uploaded. Let me see how long it takes. So it's done. You can see it is going on review pending because we can approve it later on. Merchant correctly done, date correctly done, expenses I created, food and grocery. You can see now it is not related to restaurant or meals. It is like grocery item. It identified from this text and set it to food and groceries, which is good. Payment method, since it's not defined here, I can include it if I want. Tax calculation, here you can see obviously it is not 100% accurate. I would prefer this should be recognized in my view, because you can see it is 35 clearly shown here, but it's not detecting here. Tax amount is showing me here, it's not detected here. So on the second invoice, it was able to detect around 60 to 70%, 50% to 60%. Let me go with the next one for you as well. Add new expenses. Three. What I'm showing you, like for every single receipt or invoice, it is going to be different. For some even bad, it can detect, some even good. Maybe as the AI progress, they are using open AI. I wish to see the accuracy in detecting much more faster, much more accurate, and get all the values for me, especially the totals for me. Test code done, name, date correct, food and groceries, reference number taken from here, and tax, okay, sorry, your date is also a bit inaccurate. I'm not seeing where I took the date from here. This clearly done a receipt on 12, but it is not 12 year as well. So you can see date is inaccurate here as well, and the total also here is inaccurate. So we can get an idea on basically for the as the photo quality goes bad, the accuracy goes bad also. So what you recommend is either you get the receipt much more clearly, Or maybe in future as it grows, the AI also get better on this as well to get much better reading scores. So it gets most of the things correctly, but still some obvious it's also going to be different. Again, as you upload your own images or your own receipts, you will see the data differs for you. And also as AI grows, maybe it keeps on changing. So there is no set result or percentage score here because it's going to be changing for every single bill values as well. So that is how you add new expense or income through OCR. Income also same procedure, you just upload it, goes into an income tab. You can also see the data, all this data from monthly, and if you click on all months, you can see how many entries are added on different months. You can easily see those results. Recent will show all the recent stuff you have added into the system. Search, you can obviously search with all the different filters, names, methods, and you can search for that as well. Reports, you know it currently. If you want to create a report for expenses or create various filter, and you can export this report either through CSV, Excel, PDF document. Here also, if you come here, you can export all the data anytime you wish. Like for October 24, I want to export all the data, you can do it. Zip, Excel, CSV, PDF. And also another option is available. We are sharing live link also available for you as well. And you have the mass uploader, like if you have a bank statement, you wish to import all the bank statement files, you just upload it here and click on view result. It will show you all the statements. You can either make it automatic so it automatically know which is a income, which is a expense, or you can specifically mention and say that I uploaded everything as in expenses. Document browser, for all the document you create and included within this, it is going to be showing you. I haven't explored this feature, so I can't comment on it. Maybe when I start using this app, if I decided, then I will try to go with and see what I can do it. I primarily now I'm using Zoho expenses. It's currently around 200 Indian rupees per month. So I'm going to compare with that to see whether it is good for me or not. Trash bin, any deleted documents entries, it will be showing here. Account setting is simple. It is going to be showing me all the account detail, subscription, and integration is something which I want to show. For example, it is having integration with QuickBooks, and also it has the integration with Webhook as well. So when if you have a form, you have a third party software application, you want to bring the data automatically into the app, you can create a webhook and connect it. If you are not sure how to use your webhook, do let me know in the comment. I will show you a relevant video for you to get a better understanding on how using it. Using webhook, we can create good automation with this. So whenever customer purchase something, whenever I purchase something, automatically everything will be added here. Automation, they have some kind of a basic automation setup with option to create recurring expense and income. You can see all the things available here. And another one is called auto assign details. So when something matches what you should do, so something like if else statement automation is available here. Income and expenses, here also it shows all the category. Obviously you can edit and remove this category. You can create your own category as well for income, expenses, and document also. Document tag, any tags which you are start using it, it will show you, it will give you some control over the tags also from here. Payment methods, as I shown you, you can create your own payment method, like you can tag the expenses or income much more better here. Tax rate, we already know, you can create a tax template for a generic tax, or if you're using this for a business purposes, you can use business tax here as well. Add receipts via email as well. This kind of email I got for my personal account. So any email I just forward to this email address, I will receive and automatically use AI to categorize those expense and income here as well. If you click here, I have specific document for specific also, like expense document, I can send it directly here. Income, I can send it here. Or if you just use this, it will use AI to automatically determine for you. Linked account available here, affiliate profile, all those are basic. So that is what SparkReceipt right now it is. It is a AI receipt app which support mobile app. My personal view, hopefully the accuracy gets improved over the time. I found very clear receipts down really well, but sometime when the receipt clarity or the image quality decreases, the data of the accuracy of images on my testing got bit reduced as well. So hopefully it will keep on improving to get better results in future. If you wish to check it out, there's a good lifetime deal available right now in the for this app. It's a special deal. I will leave the link in the description. You can check it out, and if it's interest you, maybe you can check it out and see whether that's something suits your need for business or personal. Once again, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.